going on, everybody? Welcome back to the 31 Days of Horror. I am your host, Mood616, and thank you once again for stopping in, guys. Yes, 31 Days of Horror, Volume 6, Day 18, happening right now. All right, guys, we're going to take it all the way back to 1960. Yes, 1960, with a film from the UK directed by Sidney Hayers, who actually did a movie that I truly, absolutely love. In Burn, Witch Burn, it was a film that came out a couple years after this one, but I've always said that that's like a true hidden gem, man. Not a lot of people talk about that one, but, you know, definitely check out that movie. Not sure if I ever reviewed it before, but with a film called Circus of Horrors. Now, for the longest time, I didn't see this movie until, I think I saw this one maybe 10 years ago for the first time, but I always thought this was a Hammer production because I knew it was from the UK. You know, the title Circus of Horrors, even the artwork and stuff, it just screamed Hammer, but this is actually not a Hammer production, which is quite interesting. This one right here actually has Donald Pleasance in it in a younger role, you know, from 1960, obviously years and years before Halloween and the hundreds and hundreds of other films that he did. Wake and Fright's like one of my favorite performances by Donald Pleasance, actually one of my favorite movies of all time, period. It's got Yvonne Monnier from Brides of Dracula in it. George Baxton is from The City of the Dead. So a lot of familiar faces. So even if you don't recognize the names, you'd recognize the faces. But pretty cool stuff. But get into the plot of this one. Basically, it starts in 1947 with our doctor played by Anton Driffing, who, of course, was in The Man Who Cheated Death, which I actually reviewed, I think last year on the 31 Days of Horror. Very, very menacing face. He's always cast perfect as, like, evil doctors and shit. But anyways, he plays our lead plastic surgeon in this movie. Starts in 1947, and basically what we get is this this close-up of this woman whose face has, like, been totally disfigured from this plastic surgery gone wrong. And he kind of freaks out, man. He's like, holy shit, man, I need to get the hell out of the UK here because this is like serious malpractice kind of thing. So that's what he does. He basically, he takes off for France. He does a little bit of face changing on himself. He goes and hides out in France, and it just says somewhere in France is where he lands. So he's in France kind of roaming around, and he finds this little girl who's got a disfigured face. And he decides that he really wants to help her. He wants to give her plastic surgery, make her beautiful again. And that's kind of his life goal. He wants to make, you know, women that have facial problems, you know, beautiful again and stuff. Anyways, so she, you know, brings him to his to her father, played by Donald Pleasance, who agrees to, you know, let the doctor, you know, do some facial surgery on him, on her and stuff. And he does. He makes her beautiful and stuff. And Donald Pleasance can't really pay him, so he kind of lets him run the circus that Donald runs. Anyways, one thing leads to another, and Donald Pleasance's character ends up getting killed in probably one of the funniest scenes in horror history. I'm not even joking. It is one of the funniest goddamn scenes I've ever seen. I was pissing my pants laughing. It's so fucking funny, man. It's just hilarious. Anyways, so with Donald dying in the film, you know, our doctor here ends up taking over the circus. And so the story jumps forward to 10 years later, and now it's the circus is a big hit. And what he's been doing is he's been transforming a whole pile of women with disfigured faces to work in the circus and stuff. And, you know, once these women don't really want to work there anymore, they mysteriously find themselves dead. So in steps an investigator, a journalist, and things like that. And yeah, that's basically the plot of our film. My thoughts on this one, man, this is a fun movie. Really, really fun movie. I love the fact that Anton Driffing plays the menacing plastic surgeon in this movie, man. He just has those really menacing eyes. He's cast perfect, man. Like, every time he plays a doctor and stuff, he has that doctor face, but he has those menacing kind of evil eyes, and even everything just kind of comes together. So it's cast very, very perfectly. The first thing I actually didn't remember, but going back into this movie, but it's actually in color, in very vibrant color. For 1960, I mean, I guess it wasn't overly uncommon to have color films, but it wasn't overly common either to have this type of vibrant color film. But it kind of makes sense because it's a circus setting, which I will say, you can tell the production value in this was pretty decent because, you know, it's pretty much all shot in the circus. Lots of different types of acts, there's lots of animals, there's, you know, there's elephants and there's, you know, tigers or lions and stuff like that. a lot of pretty cool stunts and stuff, and just a lot of interchanging kind of set pieces and things like that. So they did a really good job with the setting. The acting overall in this movie is really good too. A lot of really great performances. Antoine Drifting definitely probably steals the show as the Doctor, but he's just so cold-hearted but so calculating at the same time. He delivers his lines so great. And also, the kills in the movie are pretty good too. I mean, it's not really a big mystery to, you know, who's doing this and stuff. It kind of tells you right away, like, who's doing this. And, you know, you can probably tell even from the synopsis. But yeah, no, the kills are probably, you know, for 1960, were probably a little bit shocking and stuff. Now, watching it nowadays is honestly they're a little bit underwhelming. But there is a couple cool ones involving a knife and things like that. So, excuse me, I got a hairball. I don't know why I said hairball. But anyways, but yeah, you know, I mean, the movie is really, really fun. The only big downfall to this movie is that it kind of gets a little bit repetitive because it's the same thing over and over again. You know, a girl gets her face reconstructed, she becomes a big star in this, she wants to go and do something else, ends up dead kind of thing. And this happens over and over again. It's just kind of different kills and stuff. But at least it's, you know, at least there's an investigative part and stuff that's kind of interesting, and some other characters kind of come into here and stuff, and then there is this whole mystery of who the surgeon actually really is and things like that. So there is a lot of different kind of plot elements, subplots in the film and things like that too. So, but all in all, it's a really entertaining film. It runs a good length, just about 90, 92 minutes, something like that. So, you know, it's pretty standard, you know, tech-wise. It's shot great. You know, the music is pretty standard stuff. You know, it's, I don't know if it's actually an original score. It does feel like it's probably library type music. For 1960, a lot of these movies, they didn't really spend the money to have these original scores and shit because it was expensive. I mean, it's not like fucking Psycho type production, even though that is from the UK too. So, or a Hitchcock production. But good movie, man. Circus of Horrors. I gotta say, I do highly recommend this movie if you're into, especially like circus horror films. I mean, that's one thing about this location for horror films. Circus, a lot of times, is underutilized. They'll have a film that's set in a carnival or a circus, and there's like, you know, just a lot of like close-up shots. There's not a lot of faraway shots. There's not a lot of, you know, sequence shots of like, you know, the actual setting and stuff like that. Where this one, it's pretty much set in there. You feel like you're at the circus. And, you know, a lot of films today, they just don't have the budgets to do it. So, you know, films that are set in circuses will be like an establishing shot and then the rest is shot up close where there's no sight of, you know, the actual setting kind of thing. So, but this one does it properly. Good setting and stuff like that. So, but yeah, I'm going to come in at about a 7 out of 10 on this one. Definitely enjoyable for what it is. And it still blows my mind it's not a Hammer production because it just feels like it probably should. But yeah, good stuff. Circus of Horrors from 1960. Good stuff. And yeah, again, if you have seen this one, you've never checked out Burn Witch Burn, definitely check out that film too, man. It's awesome. I think Scorpion released on Blu-ray. Yeah, I think Scorpion released it. So anyways, guys, that's going to do it for day 18 here on the 31 Days of Horror Volume 6. I'll be back tomorrow, day 19. And yeah, until then, deuces!